ET's first look at a different kind of outfit change video. As you can see, the effect of this video is fantastic. As this beautiful woman is walking, various clothes are swapped out very naturally. Usually to achieve similar special effects, we rely on paid, non-open source models available online. But today, we are going to challenge ourselves to achieve this effect using the WAN 2.2 open source model. Actually, today's video doesn't introduce any brand new techniques or models. We are simply integrating and applying some of the techniques we discussed previously. I have built all the workflows onto Running Hub. You can access this platform via Running Hub in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is a fantastic online workspace. This is because it follows up immediately whenever new technologies and models appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This way, you can receive 1,000 free points. Furthermore, you will also receive 100 bonus points every day you log into Running Hub. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Okay, next, let's look at the specific implementation method for this effect. By carefully observing this video, we can generally see that it is generated using a keyframe method. For each keyframe, we must have a different outfit. Therefore, we will use our first technique called outfit transfer, which is the unique virtual try-on model we discussed previously. This workflow consists of two parts. The first part is extracting the clothing from the reference image, displaying it according to the required pose, and finally putting it onto the person's body. Let's run it first to see the effect. First, we extract the clothes and then we put them onto the person. You will find that this effect is very beautiful. Here, we primarily use two LoRAs. One is called Extract Outfit, which is for extracting clothes. The other one is called Clothes Transfer, which handles clothing migration, putting the clothing onto a different person. I have explained this workflow in detail in that video. Here, I will just give a brief overview. When using this workflow today, we will only use the upper part. This is because we need to change outfits and characters quite frequently. Therefore, our method of use has slightly changed. When using it, disable the clothes transfer portion. We only need the upper part. Next, we selected four images, which represent four different styles of clothing. For each image, you can use the workflow described above to extract the corresponding clothing. The extracted results look like this, and generally, there are no issues. Now we move on to our second workflow. This second workflow involves applying the outfit change processing specifically to the keyframes extracted from a video. This process must be automated. First, let's look at the video I selected. Selecting the video is quite important. Based on the overall silhouette of the clothing, try to choose a video with a corresponding viewpoint. We recommend using full body videos. If a full body shot is not possible, try to use a perspective from the knees up. This will better showcase the clothing overall. You need to extract 4 keyframes based on the total frame count of your original video. Of course, extracting 5 frames is also fine. It depends on how many outfits you want to change. I am using 4 frames. I take 1 frame every 30 frames. In the end, I obtained these 4 images. Take a look. These 4 images are evenly distributed throughout the different parts of the video. Similarly, I have 4 outfits here. These 4 outfits are the ones I just extracted. Since I have no specific requirement for the order, I use this node to combine them into a batch. Below is our model loading section. Essentially, what we are doing now is outfit swapping. Therefore, the method used is the same as the outfit swapping technique we discussed in the last lesson. We use the Million Image Edit Plus model, along with our acceleration LoRA. This is our text encoder and our VAE. Next, we move into the outfit swapping portion. Here, we will use a loop since we have 4 outfits and 4 keyframes. So, we first retrieve all 4 images from the video and all 4 extracted clothing images. Then, based on the loop count or the index, we retrieve them individually. This ensures that for every loop iteration, a different outfit and a different keyframe are retrieved. After that, we need to scale it up to 1,000,000 pixels. We handled this similarly in previous workflows. Following that is the actual outfit transfer. We first use the outfit transfer LoRA. In the text encoding section, please note that the trigger word must be written this way. This is a basic requirement of this LoRA. Then we have the 2 reference images. The first one is the keyframe we want to change the outfit on, and the second is the clothing image you want to swap in. We connect them separately and perform the sampling process. Because we used acceleration, I set the sampling steps to 8. The CFG is 1.0. After the image is decoded, I directly output it into the keyframe image and update it to value 1. However, we only need the last 4 images in the end. Therefore, I use this node to extract them. These are the 4 images you see now. Thus, each keyframe is wearing a different outfit. The logically complex part here is the looping section. Pay attention. In ComfyUI, there is no concept of an empty list within the loop. Therefore, we must use the existing 4 keyframes to store the generated results, and then extract only the last 4 images. Of course, you can use other methods. For example, you can place any random image to initially store the final data. Then, in the end, you just discard that randomly placed image. The only thing everyone needs to remember is that you cannot initialize an empty list or an empty batch to store the results. Doing so will cause an error. This is a key point to note when dealing with loops. Then we move on to our last workflow. This workflow is the method we shared in previous videos for creating vase long videos or vase one-shot videos. If you are unfamiliar with this workflow, you can refer to that video, which contains a very detailed explanation. We'll go over it quickly. Since this is a vase and it is the WAN 2.2 version, we must select the fun version of vase. It has both a high noise model and a low noise model. Since it is loaded in module form, we must use KGIS node to load the extra models. The encoder and VAE remain unchanged. For the acceleration LoRa, I am using the traditional light X to X. I didn't use the newest version. Following this, we have the basic configuration here. There is one extra parameter here. Overlaps, the biggest feature of vase is that it generates the next segment of the video by referencing the last few frames of the previous video. Overlaps indicates how many frames you reference. I recommend setting it to 7. If the value is too high, the effect might not be as good. We divide the video generation into 2 parts. The first part is a standard start to end frame sequence. We put the first image and the second image into it. Be careful to clearly distinguish which is the first image and which is the second. From this perspective, the person is constantly moving forward, so the car keeps getting smaller. When selecting these images, pay attention, this is the first frame, because at this point, they have clearly moved forward. Similarly, the third frame later shows them further away from the car. And this is the fourth frame. Don't mix them up. If you mix them up, the start to end frame generation will look confusing. The start to end frame generation itself is straightforward. After encoding using the WAN video vase start to end frame node, we can perform the sampling process. I display the result here. It represents the transition from the first frame to the second frame. The mechanism for generating the third and fourth frames is slightly different. For their generation, we still use a looping method. Since we still have 2 keyframes remaining, we need to loop twice. In each loop, I essentially utilize the last 7 frames of the previous video to infer the next video segment. Finally, we achieve this effect. Take a look. The overall result is quite beautiful. Of course, you can also use the WAN 2.2 video repair workflow to upscale it. That way, the overall effect might be even better. So among the workflows we discussed today, only the second one is new. The other 2 have been explained in detail in previous videos. My main focus in this video was really on the thought process and concepts. That is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.